I got a question. What's going on? Not what's going on as in, yo man, it's been a long time, what's going on? What's going on as in, yo, the Canadiens just blew a 4-goal lead against the Rangers and they lost to Boston 8-1. What's going on? That kind of what's going on. So let's talk a little bit about the Habs. It's always about the Habs, right? I actually haven't been tuning into the majority of these games where we've seen these poor results on the score sheet from Les Canadiens. And a lot of that has to do with scheduling. Of course, I'm a primary Canucks fan. I'm also a college student towards the end of my third semester, so finals are coming up. Actually, I only have one final. The other things I have to work on are big projects for school because I am in a media program. But I haven't been keeping up with the Montreal Canadiens too much on the actual watching games side of things. But trust me, I have been following them. I still have the notifications enabled. I still check the highlights and I still do my due diligence when it comes to understanding what's going on with the team. But what's going on, man? The Habs haven't found a way to really take control of this November. Carey Price this month is at an .886 save percentage, and that's not great. He got pulled for the first time in like 100-something games the other night. The Boston Bruins just had their way with the Canadiens, and the Habs didn't look so great against the Rangers either when they blew a 4-0 lead and lost it 6-5. It doesn't look too great at the moment for the Canadiens of Montreal, but obviously you have to take a look at it. It's a small sample size. It's 1 month out of however many months you play in an NHL year. So obviously the world is not coming to an end, but at the same time, it's not good to look at the results like this and say, eh, it's okay. So what's going on? Let's talk a little bit about the Habs. Carey Price, I already talked about it. He hasn't been Carey Price this month, but you could make the argument that that's okay. Because last year, Carey Price also had a pretty weak November. His save percentage in November this year is .886. His save percentage in November last year was .886. Yeah, the same numbers. In fact, he bounced back really nicely in December last year with a .917 save percentage, and by the time January rolled around, he was playing really, really well. So Carey Price has gone through this same kind of thing literally a year ago. So if Carey Price is Carey Price and he proves to us that he is still Carey Price, I wouldn't be surprised if by January he's a .930+ goaltender. So I'm not necessarily too worried about Price, but at the same time, you can't look at these past few games and say that Carey Price has been Carey Price. Let's talk a little bit about some of these goals that the Canadiens have been letting in. Not all of them have to do with Carey Price. Obviously, you'd like to see a few more saves out of Carey Price, but a lot of that has to do with the defense and the coverage and the line changes and the giveaways, and all that stuff are controllable to some varying degrees. But you can't say that the entirety of the Montreal Canadiens' goals against catalog over the past week has been completely on the fault of one person or two people or whatever. Some of these goals were just Boston being really, really gosh darn good, or the Rangers having their moments. But the Canadiens have been doing their fair share of things to allow these things to happen too. As I said, defensive coverage. Guys like Ben Chiarot not catching up to their checks, leaving men open in front. Petrie giving up big, bad giveaways in their own zone to set up the other team. This is a bad stretch. And this is something that won't be permanent, but it's certainly not something to look at and say, eh, we're fine. Because the reality is the Canadiens are not fine. Cody Kanyemi is not doing the best that he could be. Guys like Carey Price aren't performing up to Carey Price standards. And for the most part, Drouin is still out. Who knew that Drouin getting injured would be this damaging to the Canadiens? But all joking aside, November hasn't seen the W's on paper. Now, I won't say that the Canadiens are not scoring goals, because they have been a really strong goal-scoring team the entire year. Just for the month of November, Thomas Tatar, 10 points in 11 games. Shea Weber, 10 points in 11 games. Freaking Ben Chiarot has 8 points in 11 games played in November. The guy is getting points, and even though he is getting points, he's still one of the players who is defensively liable when it comes to giving up some of these really good chances for the other team. In the Boston game yesterday, I was kind of sitting at home. I was like, okay, I just finished up an assignment. I gotta do what I gotta do next. And then I started getting the notifications pouring in. 1-0, 1-1, then 2-1, 3-1, 4-1, 5-1, 6-1, 7-1, 8-1. And then I was like, okay, what the heck happened? What the hell happened to the Canadiens? And then I looked at the Reddit and I looked at the Twitter and I watched the highlights and I was like, boy, oh boy, what's going on? What's going on? I'll tell you what, man, I still think this team can make the playoffs, and I still think this team has what it takes to get out of this rut and actually become better. But what are the steps that the team is going to need to go through in order to get there? There's got to be something that needs to change with the defensive deployment or the defensive positioning and the awareness on either side, coaching and player-wise, because anybody looking at the Canadiens and looking at the goals scored yesterday by the Bruins can definitely notice that there was something wrong with how the Habs were playing. And something will need to change. Something is going to change. You can't expect the Habs to play that bad for an extended amount of time. But, you know, it's still pretty ugly to look at. And that's ultimately what we have right here. As I said, November hasn't been terrible for the Canadiens. Deneau is at 8 points. Suzuki, the guy's at 7 points in 11 games this month. But some of the other guys have kind of been slowing down. Brendan Gallagher, he's at 6 points in 11 games. Domi, 5 points in 11 games. This is why the idea of Domi and Gallagher movement within the lineup has kind of presented itself. Because the big scorers, the guys that you expect to carry the team, haven't been carrying the team. Instead, you're being carried by Shea Weber and Ben Chiarot offensively, as well as Thomas Tatar. You know who has the most goals for the Canadiens in November? It's Shea Weber. He's got 6, followed up by Lehkonen, Tatar, and Suzuki. You're not being carried by the guys who are supposed to carry your team. And Drouin, yeah, the guy's out, so you can't really put anything on him, but the team needs to step up. The players that are considered the leaders of this team, they need to step up offensively, at least on the forward side of things, because Shea Weber can only do so much as a Shea Weber can do. Get a whole bunch of points, get 6 goals, but at the end of the day, you still gotta have your forward stars playing like your forward stars. When we're 27 days into November, November's practically over, and your best goal-scoring forward in the month is Arturi Lehkonen, on a team that has Gallagher, on a team that has Tatar, on a team that has Domi, I don't think you're playing to the best of your abilities. And that's no disrespect to Arturi Lehkonen. The guy got 4 goals this month, which is great. But for a team that's one of the strongest offensively in the league, you would expect more. Which is why we need to get more. Whether it's Nick Suzuki or Cousins or Thompson or whoever, somebody needs to step up. And I have no doubts that somebody will step up, or maybe several people will step up slowly together to combine for a team that actually does a pretty good job at winning hockey games in December. But right now, November is coming up to an end, and what's going on with the Habs is that they haven't found a way to win hockey games to the best of their ability. And that's the key thing, to the best of their ability. We know they can play better. They've been better this season. We know that they're better than the results that they've been producing over the past little while. Which is why it's frustrating to see the team lose the way it has. But ultimately, teams will go through ups and downs. Teams will have their good moments. Teams will have their bad moments. The Canadiens' bad moments might have just already passed. Or maybe they'll extend for a few more games. But one thing's for sure, this loss against Boston, this loss against New York, it's not going to be taken lightly. And the fan base has been saying their things. Everybody's freaking out online. Everybody's freaking out on social media, and that's okay. Because at the end of the day, we all care. And at the end of the day, I think we all kind of know that this team will be better than this. Maybe as soon as next week. But what's going on with the Habs is that they're going through a downtime, and I believe they're going to take the necessary steps to fix that in the near future. The really near future. Hope you enjoyed this video, social, Slay and I. And I have to go to broadcast law. I have class in 10 minutes. And Bye.